If you didn't already know, Tesla is hinting at silicon nanowire technology for batteries. This could be through a possible partnership with Amprius. Amprius, founded in 2009, is a pioneer and established leader in the production of silicon anodes for high energy density lithium-ion batteries. The company has developed new manufacturing methods for producing 100% silicon anodes, setting a precedent for scalable silicon anode production. Amprius Technology has developed a unique manufacturing tool that employs a multi-step deposition process to grow 3D structures on a moving foil in a roll-to-roll system. So why use silicon in the anode? Because silicon is 10 times more energy dense than graphite, which is seen here as carbon in this graph. And it's also leaps and bounds ahead of the competition when it comes to weight, meaning your new EV will be super light, allowing it to travel many more miles on a single charge. This also opens the doors up to electric aircrafts. So for those who didn't know how a battery works, if you look at this, on the left side we've got the cathode, which has the nickel, magnesium, cobalt, illustrated in these greeny yellow diamonds. And on the right side we've got the graphite in the anode. So the lithium ions on full charge will be in the graphite, and then discharging, they'll move towards the cathode. So there's a limiting factor with graphite. It can only hold so many lithium ions. This is why it's been looked to be replaced with the silicon nanowire technology, which will hold 10 times more of the lithium ions. Though the issue and why silicon isn't already used is because it expands with the heat and breaks the battery. So this is where the silicon nanowire technology comes in. In 2007, researchers at Stanford University discovered a solution to the problem associated with silicon in batteries using new techniques in nanotechnology. They were able to store lithium in tiny silicon nanowires. These nanowires are about 1/1000th the thickness of a sheet of paper. The silicon nanowires still swell when they take up lithium, but the nanowires keep the silicon from fracturing and breaking apart. The result is the world's first 100% silicon nanowire anode for the lithium-ion batteries, and Amprius Technologies was formed to bring this revolutionary battery technology to the world. Quick side note, Tesla has already been using small amounts of silicon in the anodes of their batteries since 2015 in the Model S. Though this technology can be achieved, there are issues with scaling production, meaning the costs are super high and don't yet make commercial sense, especially in terms of a mass-produced vehicle. It could, however, make more sense in such vehicles as the Tesla Roadster and the Plaid models. It can be seen here in a tweet from Elon Musk. Produced in volume, not just in lab, is not far, probably 3 to 4 years. Although in 2017, Elon Musk said we would have full self-driving by the end of the year. So take this with a grain of salt. Here's another tweet from a battery expert, Ying Shirley Meng. We should pay attention to cost per kilogram. Even those nanowires work, which I doubt, to produce consistent quality in metric ton scale at $10 per kilo, it will be sci-fi for now. And here's a quote from the CEO of Amprius himself. We have to scale up to 30 times bigger, he says, otherwise we cannot make money. Here's another quote from the CEO, according to a plane that they supply batteries for Airbus. Tucson, the Airbus contract is both a lifeline and a yellow flag. We charge them a crazy price for the batteries, he says. That kind of price is not sustainable. The batteries crafted in Sanibel, in other words, are akin to suits sewn on Savile Row. Bespoke, expensive, and therefore at risk. If we cannot scale up, Sun says, of the California operation, it will die. So if you're an investor in Novonix, watch my videos, or study Novonix, you'd probably know that they are largely involved with synthetic graphite and looking to ramp up production, which will be a large amount of their revenue in 2030. So my conclusion is, this shouldn't affect them too much, although I could see this technology taking place later years. I think it's too far off, and possibly we could see a mix of synthetic graphite with the silicon to perform battery, or possibly in the future, this could take over. Though I see Novonix is still a good investment and still making a lot of money from their synthetic graphite.